Hello my dear students, in the previous class we discussed about some question based on probability. In this class also we are going to do the question based on probability only, but that concept is related to set theory there. Okay, so first before going to start the concept of probability, we can revise the formulas, everything which we studied there. Okay, so in set theory first we studied if A and B are any two sets there, then what we studied, one formula is there, number of elements in A union B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A intersection B. Okay, and then now the same formula how we can rewrite for probability, it will come probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. The same formula now we are going to use for probability. Probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. In this only, if A and B are mutually exclusive. If A and B are mutually exclusive, then what we said when we are saying the events A and B are mutually exclusive, yes, when their intersection is equal to 5. So if A and B are mutually exclusive, then we know A intersection B is equal to 5. It means no elements will be there in A intersection B. Therefore, probability of A intersection B will be equal to 0. So in that case, we will get here probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. So this is the formula, and if A and B are mutually exclusive, then the formula will be probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B. After that, we can check how we can relate each event with the set theory there. Like first one is probability of A or B. Probability of A or B. Or means what? Union. So it can be written as probability of A union B. Similarly, probability of A and B. Probability of A and B, how we can rewrite? And means that is intersection. Probability of A intersection B. Then next one, probability of not A. Probability of not A, that is denoted by probability of A dash or A complement there. And how we will calculate the probability of A dash? That will be equal to 1 minus probability of A. Clear? Okay. Now, next one is probability of neither A. Probability of neither A nor B. Okay. So for this, I am just giving an example there. Any example there, like suppose a person, he is neither a politician nor an actor. I am talking about a person which is neither a politician nor an actor. So what does it mean there? What is that person? Yes, he is not a politician and he is not a, yes, he is not an actor there. So what I said there, I said the person which I am talking about, whom, is neither a politician nor an actor there, means he is not a politician and he is not an actor. Correct? So this one, neither A nor B, when we will write down there, how it will come? He is not a politician. Not a politician means what will come? A dash there. Okay, A dash intersection B dash. A dash intersection B dash. I said he is neither a politician nor an actor, which means he is not a politician and he is not an actor. So when and will come, then what will come? Intersection there. So probability of A dash intersection B dash, or we can write in this way, probability of A union B the whole dash. A dash intersection B dash. If you want, you can check with the Venn diagram there. Venn diagram we studied in set theory there. If A and B are any two sets there. So now A dash intersection B dash, the area which is common to both A dash and B dash. This is the set A. So A dash means all the elements which does not belongs to A will come in A dash. So in this way it will come. Okay. And then B dash, what will come? All the elements which does not belongs to B. So all the elements which does not belongs to B will come in B dash there. So in this way, we have drawn the diagram. Now intersection means the common area we need there. So which area is there which is not common? Yes, this area is not common there, correct? And similarly, this portion also is not common there. And what is this portion called in set theory when we are drawing the Venn diagram? Yes, that is A union B. So A dash intersection B dash can be written as A union B, the whole dash. Okay, this concept is clear. Okay, then next one is probability of A intersection B dash. Probability of A intersection B dash. So just to check here, this one will be clear when you will draw the Venn diagram there. A intersection B dash. A intersection B dash. So just to check what will come here. A and B, we drawn two sets. Now we are finding what will be A intersection B dash. Means the element should be there in A and it should be there in B dash there. And then common element we need there. So the element which is there in A. Suppose this is A and this is B. So the element which is there in A means this element will come. Correct? Okay. And the element which is there in B dash. Except B, rest all the elements will be in B dash there. So in this way it will come. Okay, all the elements which does not belongs to B will be in B dash there. Now just to check, what is the area common in A and B dash? The area which is common to both A and B dash. I think this is the only area which is common to both A and B dash. So how we can find out this area? Just to check, from the set A, which portion we have to subtract? This portion, correct? And what is that portion called? Yes, intersection. So probability of A intersection B dash can be calculated using the formula probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. From the set A, if we will subtract the area which is common to both A and B, then we will get probability of A intersection B dash. Similarly, if you have to calculate probability of A dash intersection B, probability of A dash intersection B, then how we will write down? Yes, all the elements of set B minus the elements which is common to both A and B. So probability of A dash intersection B will be equal to probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. So I hope all these formulas are clear to you. Okay, now we can solve the question based on these formulas. In case of any doubt, just draw the Venn diagram. Then everything will be clear to you. Okay. So as questions are there with you, I am just writing what are the things given in the question. So in the first question, it is written, fill in the blanks in the following table. So in the first question, you can check. It is given probability of A 1 by 4, probability of B 1 by 3. Probability of A intersection B is equal to 1 by 12. We have to find probability of A union B. So directly we can use the formula. Probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Just to substitute the values, probability of A 1 by 4 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 12. We can simplify it. Just to do the cross multiplication, then it will be equal to 3 plus 4. 7 by 12. 7 by 12 minus 1 by 12, which will be equal to 6 by 12. Now you can cancel it. Then answer will be equal to 1 by 2. Clear? Okay. Now, in this only, second question is written. Probability of A 0.67. Probability of B, we have to calculate. Probability of A intersection B 0.26 and probability of A union B 0.52. So as already I wrote the formula, shall I substitute directly? Okay. Probability of A union B, it is given 0.52. Probability of A 0.67. Plus probability of B, we have to calculate there. And then probability of A intersection B is written 0.26. So 0.52 equal to 0.67 minus 0.26. So first we can subtract them. Okay, so it will be equal to 7 minus 6, 1, 6 minus 2, 4. So we'll get there 0.41 plus probability of B. Now 0.41, if I will shift here, then what will come? Yes, it will get subtracted there. So you don't have to write that minus 0.41. After subtracting, what will be the answer that you can write directly here? What will come? 2 minus 1, 1. 5 minus 4, 1. So we'll get there. Probability of B is equal to 0.11. I hope how to use the formulas are clear to you. Okay. Now, next question. Third one. Since we need the formula, so I'm not rubbing that formula. Okay. So in the third one, it is given probability of A 1 by 4. Probability of A 1 by 4. Probability of B 2 by 5. Probability of A intersection B, we have to calculate. Probability of A union B is given here 1 by 2 minus probability of A intersection B. So can we shift probability of A intersection B here? So that negative sign will become positive there, and 1 by 2 we can shift. Before shifting here, we can do the cross multiplication also. So I am shifting the expression here, probability of A intersection B. Here just to do the cross multiplication, 5 plus 4 to the 8. So 5 plus 8 will be equal to 13 by 20 minus 1 by 2. Now just to check, 20 is a multiple of 2. So we can make the denominator equal. If you want, you can do the cross multiplication also. Your choice only how you want to do the subtraction. So here, can we make the denominator equal? Okay, so we have to multiply it by 10. So now denominators are equal, directly we can subtract the numerator, then it will be equal to 13 minus 10, which is equal to 3. So probability of A intersection B will be equal to 3 by 20. Clear? Okay, now we can check the next question. In question number 2, it is given probability of A 4 by 7, probability of A 4 by 7, probability of B 1 by 7, find probability of A or B. A or B means what we have to calculate or represent? Yes, union. We have to calculate probability of A union B. It is given A and B are mutually exclusive. What is the meaning of mutually exclusive? Yes, no element is there. No common element is there in A and B. Means what will come? Yes, number of elements in A intersection B is equal to 5. Then what will be the probability of A intersection B? Yes, probability will be equal to 0. So direct we can use the formula, probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B. This one already we wrote as formula only. If A and B are mutually exclusive, then probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B. Now just to substitute the value, 4 by 7 plus 1 by 7. If denominators are equal, don't do the cross multiplication. Directly add or subtract the numerator there. So it will be equal to 5 by 7. Okay. Now, third question. In the third question, it is written, if E and F are events such that probability of E is equal to 1 by 2, probability of F is equal to 1 by 6, probability of E and F. And means what? Yes, intersection. So it is given probability of E intersection F is equal to 1 by 6. First question is find probability of E or F. E or F means what we have to calculate? Yes, we have to calculate probability of E union F. And what is the formula? Yes, probability of E union F is equal to probability of E, that is 1 by 2 plus probability of F, 1 by 6 minus probability of E intersection F. So 1 by 6 and 1 by 6 will get cancelled, we'll get the answer is equal to 1 by 2. So first part over. Now in this only the second part is written there. Find the probability of not E and not F. Probability of not E and not F there. So just we'll rewrite this one. Not E meaning what? Yes, not E means E dash. So we have to find out probability of E dash. And means what? Intersection. Not F. Not F meaning F dash. So we have to calculate probability of E dash intersection F dash. And we know in set theory we studied there. E dash intersection F dash can be written as E intersection F the whole dash. Probability of E dash intersection F dash can be written as E intersection F the whole dash. So how we can find out the complement of E intersection F, E union F, not intersection, okay. E dash intersection F dash is equal to probability of E union F the whole dash, okay. And how we will calculate the complement of E union F? Just now we have calculated E union F. So this can be written as 1 minus probability of E union F, because we know probability of occurrence of an event plus probability of non-occurrence of the event is equal to 1. So now we know the value, so that we can substitute here 1 minus 1 by 2. So cross multiplication will give you the answer 1 by 2. In this only the next, now that part is over. Now question number 4. In question number 4, it is written events E and F are such that probability of not E or not F. Probability of not E or not F is equal to how much it is given? 0.52. This information is given. Now question is state whether E and F are mutually exclusive. So, whenever you are going to solve the question, first check what is the meaning of mutually exclusive. If E and F are mutually exclusive, then yes, their intersection will be equal to 5. So, probability of intersection should be equal to 0. So, here we have to check whether the probability of their intersection is equal to 0 or not. Now, we can check. We'll write down there what will come. Not E meaning what? Yes, not E meaning E dash, correct? Or meaning what? Yes, union. Not F meaning F dash. So this information is given. Probability of E dash union F dash is equal to 0.52. Again, E dash union F dash. How we can rewrite this one? Yes, that is equal to E intersection F the whole dash is equal to 0.52. If you want, you can just check here. Okay. If you have any problem, just mark two sets there. E and F. E dash union F dash means we can take the elements which are there in E dash or which are there in F dash there. So the element which are in E dash, which one will come in E dash? Yes, all these elements will come in E dash there, and in F dash what will come? All the elements which does not belongs to F dash. Okay, so all this area region will come. So which region is not coming? Only the common region, the region which is common to both E and F. So that's why we wrote in this way. This can be written as probability of E intersection F the whole dash is equal to 0.52. So how we can calculate the probability of E intersection F? Yes, that is equal to 1 minus 0.52. And what will be 1 minus 0.52? Yes, that is equal to 0.48. So whether we are getting the probability of intersection equal to 0? No. So just write down there, not equal to 0. Therefore, E and F are not mutually exclusive. If they are mutually exclusive, then their intersection should be equal to 5 and probability of the intersection should be 0. So I hope the question is clear. Okay. Now we can check the next question. In question number 5, it is written, check whether the following probabilities are consistently defined, means whether this condition is possible or not. So in that first question is written, probability of A 0.5, probability of B 0.7, probability of A intersection B, probability of A intersection B 0.6. So whether the probability is consistently defined or not. Now just imagine there, A is a set, B is another set there, okay. And in A intersection B, what we are writing? Yes, the element which is common to both A and B. Till here that is clear? Okay, so in A intersection B, the element will be more than A, more than B, or what can be? What can be? We know if A and B are two sets, so either either A intersection B, maximum case, either it can be equal to A or it can be equal to B there. It will never, number of elements will not be more than A or will not be more than B. Correct? Till here it is clear? Okay. So either probability of A intersection B, maximum it can be equal to probability of A. I am not saying this will be equal. Maximum will be equal to probability of A or it can be equal to probability of B. It will not, never exceeds the probability of A or probability of B. That is clear, because in A intersection B, we are writing the element which is common to both A and B. So if it is common, means obviously its probability either less than or equal to probability of A or less than or equal to probability of B. Now just to check in the question, what is given? Probability of A intersection B 0.6, and here probability of A is 0.5, which is not true. So just write down there, probability of A intersection B should be less than or equal to probability of A or probability of B. Therefore, this one, this probability is not consistently defined. Okay. Now, in this only, second question is written, probability of A is equal to 0.5, probability of B is equal to 0.4, and probability of A union B is equal to 0.8. Now, can we check what will be the probability of A intersection B? Okay, using the formula, probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Probability of A union B, it is given 0.8 is equal to 0.5 plus 0.4 minus probability of A intersection B. Again, probability of A intersection B, we can shift here. 0.5 plus 0.4 is 0.9 minus 0.8 will be equal to 0.1. Now just to check, probability of A intersection B is 0.1, which is less than probability of A and less than probability of B. And it is not negative also. So this probability is consistently defined. Okay. Now, the next one, question number 6. So, I will read the question and accordingly what are the things given, that only I am going to write. Okay. Now, in question number 6, it is written, in a class plus 1, of a school, 35% of the students study maths. So probability of the students studying maths, so maths I am writing probability of M, is equal to 35%. 35% meaning what? Yes, 35 by 100. And then 40% study biology. So probability of biology is equal to 40%. So we can write down here 40 by 100. And 15% of the class study both maths and biology. Both maths and biology means, yes, intersection. Maths, intersection, biology, it is given 15%. So which will be equal to 15 by 100. If a student is selected at random from the class, find the probability that he will be studying maths or biology. So we have to select the student. He is studying either maths or biology. Means what we have to calculate? Yes, we have to calculate M union B. So already values are given. We can substitute the value. Formula will be probability of M plus probability of B minus probability of M intersection B. Probability of M, 35 by 100. Probability of B, 40 by 100 minus 15 by 100. 35 minus 15. So 35 minus 15 will be equal to 20. Okay. And 40 plus 20 will be equal to 60. So probability of student studying either maths or biology will be equal to 60 by 100. And since the question is given in percentage, we can write the answer also in percentage. 60%. Okay, so I think how to use the formulas is clear. Okay, now next question. In question number 7, it is written, two students, Anil and Ashima, appeared in an exam. The probability that Anil will qualify the exam is 0.05. So, probability of Anil qualifying the exam is 0.05, and that Ashima will qualify the exam is 0.10. So, already A is there, so I am writing S for Ashima. Okay. 0.10. The probability of passing at least one of them is 0.13. At least meaning what? Either this or this. Either one or more than one. So at least means union. So it is given probability of A union S is equal to 0.13. What is the probability that? First condition is, both will qualify the exam. Both means Anil and Ashima both. Means what we have to calculate? Yes, we have to calculate the intersection. So, formula is probability of A union S is equal to probability of A plus probability of S minus probability of A intersection S. Substitute the values. 0.13 is equal to 0.05 plus 0.10 minus probability of A intersection S. So probability of A intersection S, we can shift here. 0.05 plus 0.10 will be equal to 0.15 minus 0.13, which will be equal to 0.02. So the probability that both will qualify the exam is 0.02. Okay. Now, second one is written there. Only one of them will qualify the exam. Only one of them will qualify the exam. Only one of them means either if Anil clearing the exam means Ashima will not clear the exam. So these can be the two possibilities. So suppose Anil cleared the exam. So in that case, Ashima will not qualify the exam. So Anil cleared and Ashima not cleared the exam. This can be one possibility. Or what can be the next possibility? Yes, Anil has not cleared the exam and Ashima cleared the exam. This can be the two possibilities there. So how we can write down there? Probability of A intersection S dash
Yes, we wrote the formula that can be written as probability of A minus probability of A intersection S. Similarly, OR means what will come? Addition. So it will be equal to probability of S minus probability of A intersection S. Now we know the values. Probability of A 0.05. Probability of A intersection S, just now we have calculated, minus 0.02, plus probability of S 0.10 minus 0.02. 0.05 plus 0.10 will be equal to 0.15 minus 0.02 into minus 0.02. So that will be equal to minus 0.04. Now you can just do the subtraction there. 5 minus 4, 1. So here it will be equal to 0.11. So I think this is clear. Okay. Now the third part is written. At least one of them will not qualify the exam. At least one of them will not qualify the exam means? Yes, both will not qualify the exam. So both will not qualify the exam means what we have to calculate? Yes, we have to calculate A intersection S the whole dash. Okay, at least one means both will not qualify the exam. So you can find out what will be probability of A intersection S the whole dash. So I think that you can do by yourself. Okay, now we can check the next question, question number 8. In question number 8, it is written, the probability that a student will pass the final exam in both English and Hindi. So probability of passing in both English and Hindi is 0.4. And probability of passing neither means he will not pass Hindi and he will not pass English. Okay, so neither means how we will write? He will not pass English and means intersection. He will not pass Hindi. Is equal to how much it is given? 0.2. So this one we can just rearrange there. E dash intersection H dash can be written as E union HD whole dash is equal to 0.2. So if probability of E union HD whole dash is equal to 0.2, what will be the probability of E union H? Yes, that will be equal to 1 minus 0.2. And I think that will be equal to 0.8. Okay. And then if the probability of passing the English exam is 0.62. So probability of E is given 0.62. And what is the probability of passing the Hindi exam? That we have to calculate. So all the things now we have here. E union H is equal to probability of E plus probability of H minus probability of E intersection H. Just substitute the value E union H 0.8 equal to probability of E is given there 0.62 plus probability of H we have to calculate minus probability of E intersection H that is given there 0.4. Now I think calculation you can do by yourself. Okay. So just to do the calculation. So I hope whatever questions we discussed today, these questions are clear to you. Okay. So all of you note down your homework. Your homework based on this type only. Okay. So your homework will be equal to exercise 16.3, question number 13 to 21 and miscellaneous exercise question number 7 and 8. So homework exercise 16.3 from question number 13 to 21 and from miscellaneous exercise 2 questions. So from this our chapter probability will be over. Thank you.